Hi, my name is Will, and this is going to be an intro to rope dart video. But before we get started, in order to start rope dart, we have to have a rope dart. Up here is a link to my tutorial on how to make a quick and easy rope dart out of cheap materials that you can find pretty much anywhere. If you have money and time, you can order a rope dart that I highly recommend from Rope Dart Academy. This is one of their Cobra darts. The Cobra darts are for more advanced students. It has BBs in here, so it hits harder, but it works just as well as their other dart, which is the silk dart. Their silk dart has beans in there, a little bit wider, but they help beginners because if you hit yourself in the face, it doesn't hurt as bad as BBs. But like I said, you can find these at Rope Dart Academy. You can find them by typing Rope Dart Academy on Google, or you can just go down to the description and click the link there. It's not a sponsored link. It's not anything of that sort. I'm just sharing my favorite things to you, the viewers. Funny enough, I'm also going to suggest something else from Rope Dart Academy, which is this book right here. If you are a serious beginner, or even if you're an intermediate or an advanced student, this I highly recommend. It breaks down everything that you should know about rope dart, such as the history, terminology, things that I find are important to have a more in-depth knowledge of rope dart. It's a great book. I use it as reference. If I forget something, or forget a name, this is what I pick up. You can find this at Rope Dart Academy as well. But that's enough of all of that. Like most YouTubers who make tutorials would say, without further ado, let's get started. So you got your first rope dart, congratulations! Now we have to attach the rope dart to ourselves. As you can see on my Cobra dart, there's already a loop at the end. But if you made your own, we're gonna have to create a loop.
Loop, haul, loop, haul!
Grab the rope, you're gonna double it over, you're gonna grab the top part of the rope, and you're going to tie it in a square knot, right through the loop. Gonna pull it through, you're gonna grab each individual tail, pull it tight, then grab both and tighten it. Grab a pair of scissors, and you're all set. You got a loop at the end. Now we need to attach it to ourselves. We're gonna take the long part of the rope, make a loop, we're gonna feed it through the loop, and we're gonna feed our non-dominant hand through that second loop. See, it's adjustable. Now we don't need this, so we can just toss it. So the proper length for rope darting, you want the rope to be as long as your wingspan plus the distance from your hand to the floor. If it's too short or if it's too long, we're gonna have to adjust that. So we're gonna make sure that the knot is on the outside of our anchor hand. Take the loose end of the rope, pull out some slack, and just wrap it around our hand. Is the length good? Let's check. If the length isn't good, wrap more to make the dart shorter, or take out some wraps in order to make it longer. Whenever we imagine a cross on the floor, it helps us work our basics. It'll become more clear as we go along. First things first, we gotta figure out where our target is, or if you're a performer, where your audience is. Differentiating which side is which is very important. The hand that the dart is tied to is considered the anchor hand. Things on that side in relation to the center line is considered the anchor side. The function of the other hand guides the dart where it needs to go. You can easily say that it leads the dart. Therefore, that is our lead hand, and anything on that side in relation to the center line is our lead side. If the dart is swinging on the sides of our body like wheels on a bus, that is considered the wheel plane. Having the dart spinning downwards in wheel plane is considered a downspin. Having the dart swinging upwards in wheel plane is considered an upspin. And if we shift our body with the dart spinning like a wall in front of us, that is considered wall plane. If the dart is spinning towards our lead side, it's considered a lead spin. If the dart is spinning towards our anchor side, that is considered an anchor spin. If we bring the dart up and spin it like blades on a helicopter, we are in horizontal plane. And like wall plane, if the dart is spinning towards our lead side, it is a lead spin. If it's spinning towards our anchor, it is an anchor spin. Maintaining straight lines in relation to our target or audience is one of the most important things to maintain. If we imagine taking the dart, dipping it in paint, and slinging it quickly in a spin, it will create a straight line on the ground. Wherever that line is pointing, the dart will follow. If we are practicing a new trick and the dart keeps hitting parts of our body, make sure the body part isn't in the line. Keeping clean lines ensures clean tricks.
So, where do we go from here?
Well, now that you're armed with the basics, you will be able to grasp concepts more clearly from the many tutorials on YouTube, aside from the ones on this channel. Flow Mayhem has a good selection, ranging from beginner to advanced. This is actually where I started my journey. Frank Hatzis also has a good selection of tutorials that covers essential moves for all rope dartists. Playlists of these tutorials will be available as links in the description. As I do an outro, I will entertain you with some rope dart. Thank you for picking my video, taking the time to watch, and I hope you have gained something from it. As someone who is trying to grow into becoming a content creator, every one comment, like, and subscription helps and will be greatly appreciated. I also have a Patreon. If you want to support me and access exclusive content, please consider a membership. Well, that concludes this introductory look at rope dart. Welcome to the dart life. Stay safe, stay present, and I'll see you in the next one.